It's a masterpiece, I say. They will cheer every word, every letter.
I wish I felt that way. I believe I can put it better. Now then attend, as friend to friend, our declaration committee. For us I see immortality in Philadelphia City. A farmer, a lawyer, and a sage, a bit gouty in the leg. You know it's quite bizarre to think that here we are, plain midwives to an egg.
Egg? What egg?
America, the birth of a new nation.
We're waiting for the chirp, chirp, chirp
of an eaglet being born. Waiting for the chirp, chirp, chirp on this humid Monday morning in this congressional incubator.
God knows the temperature's hot enough to hatch a stone, let alone an egg.
We're waiting for the scratch, scratch, scratch of that tiny little fellow. Waiting for the egg to hatch on this humid Monday morning in this congressional incubator.
God knows the temperature's hot enough to hatch a stone, but will it hatch an egg? The eagle's going to crack the shell of the egg that England laid.
Yes, sir, we can tell, tell, tell on this humid Monday morning in this congressional incubator.
And just as Tom here has written, though the shell may belong to Great Britain, the eagle inside belongs to us.
And just as Tom here has written, we say to hell with Great Britain, the eagle inside belongs to us.
By God, I have had this Congress. For 10 years, King George and his Parliament have gulled, cullied, and diddled these colonies, and still this Congress refuses to grant any of my proposals on independence, even so much as the courtesy of open debate. Good God, what in hell are they waiting for?
Sit down, John! Sit down!
Sit down, John!
Sit down, John!
For God's sake, John!
I say vote yes, vote yes, vote for independence.